Hello, myself is Professor Praveen Bhandare. I welcome you for the video lecture on a topic screen analysis for determining the particle size distribution. It is the part of mechanical operations. In this lecture, we'll try to understand what is screen analysis, how screen analysis is carried out, and what is the necessity of determining the particle size distribution. Now, to begin our discussion, first of all, let us understand what is screen analysis. So, basically, it is the method of separating solid sample into particles of various size ranges using set of standard screens. Now, the standard screen means there is a definite relationship between the opening of the screen and the wire diameter which is used for making that screening surface. So, in front of you, there are two standards specified, IS 1607-1997 and ASTM standard C136. Now, the pictures of the two standard screens, which I have taken from some resources, like the first is about ASTM test sieves, and this resource or this image I have taken from Gilson, and the another image is about the test sieve I have taken from a IndiaMart. So, basically, these screens or these test sieves are manufactured as per the pre-decided standard, and therefore, there is a particular relationship between the set of the screens which falls into that standards. So, when these screens or when the set of this standard screen is utilized for analyzing the particles, we call that as a screen analysis. Now, what is the necessity of screen analysis? First, to determine particles of various size ranges in a given sample, to determine the average representative size of particles in a given sample. Say, for example, when the particles in a given sample differs in their sizes, now for the calculations, many a times it is required to use the single value irrespective of the particles of various size ranges present in that sample. So, to determine the single representative value of the particle size for that sample, screen analysis is used. To determine the performance of crusher and grinder, we require that the particles may be a feed or product of a single size. So, that particular particle size distribution which is used for the calculation related to crushers and grinder, or say crushing and grinding, the screen analysis is used. Even in order to evaluate the performance of crusher and grinder, we can do the screen analysis. For a grading of given sample or food grains, screen analysis is carried out. For example, say in case of sugar factory, even though the basic feedstock is a sugar cane juice, however, after all manufacturing is over and after crystallization, we often see that we get the sugar crystals of various size ranges. And therefore, in order to understand the grading of the material obtained, the screen analysis is necessary. Even when we use the gravels and sand for the construction activity, the packing density and strength of concrete depends upon typical size range of gravels and sand. So, to understand whether the sample is in that size range or not, the screen analysis is necessary. Now, basically, there are two ways of analyzing the given sample. The first is differential analysis and another is a cumulative analysis. Now this differential analysis is basically the representing the data obtained after the screening using a set of standard screen in terms of mass fraction of material retained versus average particle size. Now when we analyze the given sample using differential analysis, the essential steps are: the sample to be analyzed is separated using set of standard test sieves. The mass of sample retained on each screen is weighed with weigh balance. The general requirement is the accuracy should be minimum 1 gram. The results are tabulated as per the standard differential analysis template, which is presented on a next slide, and the average size of the particle and mass fraction of the material retained on each screen is calculated. Now this table is the template for substituting the data obtained after the screening in order to have the differential analysis. So the first column is screen opening expressed in mm. Average screen opening is calculated from the data entered in a first column. Then the mass of material retained on each screen is noted down and the mass fraction is determined. So generally we select the screen so that the no material is retained on the first screen. Then the average size of the particle present in a sample retained on the second screen is equal to the summation of particle size of the screen above that screen and the screen which is under consideration divided by 2. And likewise, say for the material retained on third screen, the average size is equal to the size of screen opening of second screen plus size opening of third screen divided by 2. And likewise, for every screen, the average screen opening is considered. Now pan means what? Pan is basically a base container which is of the similar size equal to that of the screen. However, it does not have any pores, that is, it is a flat impervious surface, metal surface, so that whatever the material passes through the sixth screen is entirely retained on a pan. Therefore, opening of the pan considered is a 0. So dp 6 plus 0 divided by 2. Likewise, the mass of the material retained on each screen is noted down, and the summation of that material retained on each screen is equal to total mass of the sample. And by using the formula of mass fraction, that is individual mass upon total mass, the mass fraction is calculated. Now, I have just entered certain values into the templates of differential analysis. The first column represents the screen opening, the second column represents the average screen opening, mass of material retained and mass fraction. So you can see the average screen opening for a second screen 9.95 is obtained as 13.2 plus 6.7 divided by 2. Likewise, 5.725 is obtained as 6.7 plus 4.75 divided by 2. The opening, the average size or average screen opening, or the average screen opening is also called as average size of the particle for the pan, is obtained as 0.6 plus size of pan, opening of the pan 0 divided by 2, that is 0.3. Likewise, the material the retained on each screen is measured and the mass fraction is calculated. Now from a differential analysis, what do we understand? We understand is like this. Say for example, consider a third screen, the mass fraction is 0.1, that means the mass percentage is 10%. So how I can interpret this? I can interpret is like this: the material retained on the screen, third screen, that is 10%, is having size greater than 4.75. Likewise, the material retained on, say, the screen opening 1.18 is, that means 47.5% material is having size greater than 1.18, or the average size is equal to 1.77 mm. 16.5% of the material is having size less than 0.6, less than 1.18 and greater than 0.6. 17.5% of the material which is retained on 2.36, has the size greater than 2.36 and less than 4.75, that is the screen above 2.36 mm screen. In this way, the single sample is analyzed in the particles of various size ranges. There is another method of expressing the screen analysis, that is a cumulative analysis. Before that, the data which is obtained after this calculation of average screen opening and the mass fraction is plotted as mass fraction of material retained versus average particle size. We can understand from this is around, majority of the particle is having the size around 2 mm. You can see this peak. You can see this peak. So, majority of the material is having size around 2 mm. Major percentage means around 47.5% is having a size around 2. So, this is how we can determine the particle size distribution, either in the form of graph or in the form of tables. Now, the second method of analysis is cumulative analysis. Cumulative means total. So, it is the ratio, it is expressed as a mass fraction of the material retained versus screen opening. The procedure for cumulative analysis is the same data which is obtained after the screening using a set of standard screen is analyzed by some mathematical manipulation. That template I'll be discussing in a next slide, but just for the timing, let us understand the procedure. So, the sample to be analyzed is separated using a set of standard sieves. The mass of sample retained on each screen is weighed with weigh balance. The results are tabulated as per the standard cumulative analysis template, and mass fraction of the material retained on each screen and passing through each screen is calculated. And finally, the cumulative mass fraction of material retained and passing through each screen is calculated. Now, please remember, the material retained means oversize and passing through each screen means undersize. So, let us understand the tabular representation of cumulative analysis. So, the first column represents screen opening. The second column is about the mass of material retained. Thereafter, the mass fraction of material retained is calculated, that x1 is equal to m1 upon capital M, x2 is equal to m2 upon capital M. Now, the important thing to note in this table is that we have not calculated the average particle size or average screen opening. We are directly determining the mass fraction, and the screen opening value is directly used for further calculation or the drawing of the graph corresponding to cumulative analysis. Now, cumulative mass fraction means what? Cumulative mass fraction is equal to the sum of the mass fraction which is retained up to the screen under consideration. For example, suppose if I consider the fifth screen, say DP5, the cumulative mass fraction for the fifth screen is equal to the sum of the mass fraction which are retained up to FIP screen, that is 0 plus x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 represent cumulative mass fraction of the material retained. So it is represented by x4 dash. X4 dash means is equal to x3 dash. X3 dash is what? The sum of the weight fraction, mass fraction of the material retained up to third screen plus the mass fraction of the material retained on the fourth screen, which is fifth screen, which is represented by x4. Likewise, cumulative weight fraction of the material retained on pan is equal to the sum of mass fraction of the material retained up to pan. Means what? The mass fraction of the material retained on first screen plus second screen plus third plus fourth plus five plus sixth and plus the material retained up to pan. Likewise, the cumulative analysis or cumulative mass fraction is determined. So obviously, the sum of mass fraction is always 1. Therefore, this x7 dash should always be equal to 1. Now, please remember, for calculating the cumulative mass fraction of material passing through the screen, the formula is 1 minus cumulative mass fraction of material retained. For example, 1 minus cumulative mass fraction of material retained on first screen is 0. So 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. So the first reading is 1. Then for the second screen, the cumulative mass fraction of undersize is equal to 1 minus x1 dash. What is x1 dash? X1 dash is the cumulative mass fraction of material retained. That means 1 minus cumulative mass fraction of the material retained is equal to cumulative mass fraction of passing through that screen or cumulative mass fraction of undersize for that particular screen. So please remember, I have told you that cumulative mass fraction of the material retained in the pan or total is always equal to 1, and therefore the last column, that is after the pan, since pan doesn't have any pores or any holes, nothing will be retained in the pan. Therefore, cumulative mass fraction passing through the pan or cumulative mass fraction of undersize for in the pan will always be 0, whereas cumulative mass fraction of the oversize in the pan will always be 1, because everything will be retained on that particular pan if all the screen above that are removed. Let us see the graphical representation. So basically, the cumulative analysis graph is the plot of cumulative mass fraction of oversize versus screen opening. Likewise, cumulative mass fraction of undersize versus screen opening. You can understand, for a screen opening is equal to 0, that is pan, everything will be retained on the pan. That means everything will be a oversized material corresponding to pan. Therefore, cumulative mass fraction is 1. However, nothing will pass through the pan, and therefore the cumulative mass fraction of undersize corresponding to the pan is basically 0. However, if you select the larger screen, everything will pass through the larger screen. That means all material through a larger screen will be the undersized material. Therefore, cumulative mass fraction of undersized material corresponding to larger screen is 1. That means 100% of the material passes through the larger screen or the topmost screen. So in this way, the nature of the graph represented by blue line, which is the graph of cumulative oversize versus screen opening, and the graph represented by a red line, which is the graph of cumulative mass fraction of undersize with screen opening, this nature of oversize and undersize graph are exactly opposite to each other. So in this way, the particles in a given sample can be analyzed using analyzed using the screen analysis method. We have discussed that there are two methods of screen analysis, differential analysis and cumulative analysis. So to summarize, the particle size distribution in a given solid sample can be determined by screen analysis. The set of standard test sieves can be used for analysis, and shaking of set of standard screen using sieve shaker facilitated the separation or say analysis. The data obtained by screen analysis can be expressed by differential analysis and cumulative analysis method. The differential analysis express the mass fraction of material retained versus average screen opening or average particle size, whereas cumulative analysis represent cumulative mass fraction of oversize and undersize material versus screen opening. Please remember the difference between 4th and 5. In 4th it is average screen opening, in a 5 it is just the screen opening. And the advantage of cumulative analysis is that there is no need to assume the average particle size. So thank you. I hope you must have understood and liked the lecture related to a screen analysis for the particle size distribution. If you like this lecture, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Praveen Bhandari, Nandurdi. I will be coming up with more relevant, useful video as per your requirement and the curriculum need. Thank you.